Take care of him and do what he has to do.
Here we go. Paul Menard, Kevin Harvick, Harvick all over the bumper. He goes to the inside, right as they cross the start finish line. Three laps of racing to go.
He's against him. He's right against him.
Paul Menard, he's still against him. He's turned him sideways. He gets
turned
around.
Oh, here comes Kevin Harvick. Harvick spins around. He had J.J. Yeley all over the back bumper. Harvick spins around, and now we have Melee on the backstretch.
This looks like this about took out the whole top four or five of the field here, and I think what you saw there was he did exactly what I thought he wouldn't do, was try to knock him out of the way. J.J. Yeley saw that same opportunity, went up and spun Harvick out.
There's Mark McFarland, had such a good run going. Let's take a look at what Paul Menard's team thought when this last caution comes out. Oh boy. They knew that he had beat him out of turn two. They were celebrating that, and then all of a sudden the caution comes
out. Wait a minute, guys. Don't look now, but guess who's running maybe third? Denny Hamlin in this race.
Second or third. It's going to be really, really interesting here. Now, you know, I knew that Harvick was going to be on his bumper there, trying to take the air off. I really didn't think he'd start beating and hitting him and trying to knock him out of the group. Yeah, he did a little bit of block here. You expect that with five to go. But here the first one, well, he shouldn't have probably done that. The second one,
he's underneath
probably,
him there.
Yeah, well, underneath him, he's, yeah.
completely underneath him. Not beside him, but completely underneath him.
Exactly, and then a lot of damage there. 59 of Stacy. Here's another view. You see him get him turned completely sideways, but then that seizes him up enough that J.J. Yaley's right there, and he makes contact with the back of him, turns around Kevin Harvick, and look, these drivers couldn't see a thing.
No. That was tough. I mean, we saw J.J. taking an opportunity to maybe sneak by this whole deal, too, but just gets in the back of Harvick a little bit.
Well, they slowed down, see?
They did.
Kevin Harvick got into Paul Menard, he got him sideways, so their momentum slowed a little bit. J.J. had a run. He was in the throttle in the center of the corner. He just came up on him so fast. That wasn't a situation where he... Watch this now. This is Clint Boyer.
No, you can see him get on the brakes hard. It just wasn't...
Yeah, just
quick enough
time. There's Clint Boyer turning around. There's Kevin Harvick right in front of him.
And see, Clint Boyer got on the brakes, got slowed down, and then got hit from behind also.
Going over to congratulate Paul Menard's crew. There's Kevin Harvick right there.
I believe that's congratulations, right?
Well, I'm not sure. He's, he can't be too mad about Harvick's one that ran into him.
If Harvick could be mad with Boyer if he wants, with J.J. Yeley. J.J. Yaley's the one that got in the back of Kevin Harvick, but I tell you, I don't think so. I think Kevin Harvick knows what happened. He knows that Paul Menard was trying to win the race. Harvick did what he had to do. Paul Menard did what he had to do. It didn't work out this time for Harvick. It did for that guy.
Crowd on their feet. Paul Menard says, "Would you please give me that checkered flag?" The first win of his career in the NASCAR Busch Series. And they'll drop it down. We'll see if Paul Menard can get a hold of that.
Oh, almost.
Very close.
That's hard to do. That's very hard to do. I waited until somebody gave it to me, or maybe he'll get it.
58 laps around this mile. Paul Menard waiting for a crew member. He'll come over and grab that flag for him. Hand it to him. He will celebrate. We're being told NASCAR said, driver of the 21, we'd like to see you in the hauler after this race. So Kevin Harvick will need to talk with the officials at the conclusion of this race. Checkered flag in hand. Paul Menard will now celebrate around his home track.
It's going to be a big celebration here in the state of Wisconsin. Looks like a pretty popular victory with a crowd, too.
Let's go right down to Chris Devoda. Krista.
Kevin Harvick climbing out of his car. Kevin, I know you flew a long way, traveled a long distance to get here. That is not the outcome you wanted. You got on the radio and gave your team a rally cry saying, "We didn't come this far to run second." Unfortunately, it's not second. It's much worse. Were you robbed of the win tonight?
Oh, I don't think so. I mean, I got a good restart and just got underneath him. And, you know, he did what he had to do to protect the bottom. And I got in the back of him. And somebody got in the back of me and we all just wrecked. So one of those deals. U.S. Coast Guard Chevrolet was okay. Should have never been behind him anyway. We were horrible in the pits tonight and just got behind. But good hard racing with a couple laps to go, and congratulations to him.
And did you give some congratulations to Paul? Was that a little congratulatory stop with Paul down there?
Yeah, I just wanted to let him know that thought he did a good job.
All right, that's Kevin Harvick. Never at a loss for words, always fun to watch. Kevin Harvick is going to head on to Sonoma, California, another 2,000 miles in a plane tonight.